day you came into this world, I received the clarity that I so desperately needed. And I hope that one day you can be as proud of me as I am of you.
Interesting day you choose to be late.
I come here out of respect for one of the heroic figures of our time, Cesar Chavez.
Diego, how well-versed were you in Cesar Chavez? Because I'm not sure if his story really translated across the border.
No, it hasn't. If you ask in the south of the border who Cesar Chavez is, they'll say, oh, a great boxer. not many know the story of Cesar and the struggle of farm workers in the 60s and 70s. Mm-hmm. And this amazing story, obviously, no one knows, you know, the amazing achievement of the great boycott and what they, the message they sent to the world. Mm-hmm. This film is an attempt to tell the story to a younger generation that needs to know this is part of their history, you know?
I was born in Yuma, Arizona, in a ranch owned by my family, but we lost it in the Depression. That's where I witnessed the injustice suffered by the people.
To be successful, we have to have an army of boycotters willing to do the hard work. The bigger the army, the bigger the success.
Farm workers in Delano, California have begun an unprecedented strike in the Central Valley.
The citizens of Delano, they respect the law.
So do we, especially the Bill of Rights.
Have you seen the headlines they're getting? That's costing us real money, Mr. Bogdanovich.
We don't have to negotiate. We have to dictate terms.
Cesar, they will shoot.
We're gonna break this damn strike.
When you play somebody that's real, it's a little bit harder. I mean, do you feel, is there fear behind that a little bit? Because you want to be true to her and to her cause?
There's definitely a awareness and a pressure that you're playing someone who's mm-hmm. still alive and mm-hmm. who's gonna probably watch your performance. But I think because there was so much that was really unknowable, a lot of Helen's character was really made up of the stories that we heard as her children say, some of the stories she told us, and really hearsay, things mm-hmm. that other people said about who she was and what she meant to the cause. You know, there is an element of knowing as much as you can know and then letting it go and really telling the story and creating the character. And for me, the most important thing was just getting her essence right.
And was there anything that you kind of discovered that you didn't originally know? Because, I mean, I've heard of him, but watching this film, it's like there's a lot of stuff that I really didn't know.
I knew there was a very important man called Cesar Chavez because I've been coming to California mm-hmm. for many years. But I didn't know what made him so special, you mm-hmm. know? And when I started doing the research, I got fascinated by the idea of and the strategy behind the boycott they organized. Mm-hmm. The very intelligent thing of doing a nonviolent movement that instead of trying to hit straight the industry that is hurting you and that is oppressing you, what they did is they went around and talked to the consumer.
It's all lies. They're saying the strike is not legal. They're painting us to look like criminals.
I failed you as a leader. And I will fast until everyone makes a pledge recommitting themselves to nonviolence.
Does he know what he's doing to you?
No, he doesn't.
They've been coming in bigger numbers ever since Chavez quit eating. How long can a man go without food?
It depends on the man, John. Everything depends on the man.
Once social change begins, can't be reversed. Can't humiliate someone who has pride. And you can't oppress someone who's not afraid anymore.